Hey all, and welcome back. So we're gonna take on yet another awesome boss. First off, let me show you guys my new shield and staff that I got the team. Save the queen, save the king, very nice additions to the party. We almost have all of the staffs, we have one more we need to get. So, what I'm gonna let you guys in on is how we're gonna get to this boss. So we take the magic carpet. Once we've sealed Hollow Bastion, we're able to take this carpet. Now this is where it gets cool. And you want to immediately summon Tinkerbell the second this fight starts. You need to be very quick about this.
Give me
strength. Okay. The reason is, this unique boss fight basically pendulum swings back and forth between melee combat and magic attack. It's kind of tricky, but we're far enough into the game to have a lot of, shall we say, strength at this point to be able to handle this situation. So the reason why we want to summon Tinkerbell is that instant regen effect, and the second reason is because the second the battle starts, these two orbs that are on the side of his hands, they block out the ability to use magic, including summons. So once you've originally destroyed the two orbs, he's gonna get stunned, and his head is gonna pop out like this. You wanna just get as much damage done as you possibly can. Without getting stuck on it. You should be able to get at least one health bar, if not more. Now, we're gonna back off of that, and all of a sudden he's basically outlawed attack, because he is invulnerable to shield, so we're gonna hit him with a lot of magic. So we're gonna try to avoid that as much as possible, but it's not gonna go really well. I'm almost half tempted to think that, and there's no way. I'm not sure how long Tinkerbell actually lasts in this fight. Didn't even know about this, like, weird ass attack.
Fire!
Anytime the shield is attacked melee-wise, you will get him to drop some MP first, which is nice because you're gonna need it. It would really suck if it didn't, because then you would be funding this entire fight with items. So anyway, now we'll rinse and repeat that exact same battle strat. Except he's also got a new trick or two because of the fact that we've lowered his health down so much, but it might be a little bit lower before it activates. There it is. This is a really shitty attack. Because there's one of two things you can do, and I'm fucking it up entirely. So he will either spin at you horizontally or vertically, and you need to dodge out of the way one way or another. And I literally think I got hit by every single really quick. We should be lucky enough to hit a boss fight like that. That was super, super easy. Only because we were on beginner and we're super high level and we've got all our best gear and everything. That boss fight was less than 4 minutes. Holy shit. Very cool, Heartless. We got Ansem's report, which is good. And I gotta say, I don't remember what that ability was that we unlocked. That's kinda neat. We're gonna turn that right on. So anyway, thank you guys for joining me for this part of the video, and I will see you guys at the last hidden boss. That's kinda neat. Peace.